Douglas Davies. This is my presentation for the fun project. I did a portable grill system. Why portable grill? It's for when you go camping. I wanted to make a grill that would be full size for operational mode, but then collapse down and save space for when you wanted to transport to go on your camping trips. Packing space is limited when you go on a trip. It's just something that interested me. Of the products I surveyed, none of them changed size between operating mode and transportation mode. They just stayed one size. Most of the grills were like tabletop grills. They were full-size grills. There was one that was a cheaper version. It said it cooked for 5 or 6 people, but it looked much smaller than the other ones. The average cooking size was 200 square inches. I think my design came out to be about 140-ish. That's plenty space to cook for a full family. My alternative designs, this was design one. The concept is that it's made of 3 sections, and the far side would slide into the middle section and be latched down with latched into place with latches, and then that would slide into a third section, which would also be latched into place with latches. The second design was a much simpler design. It would just be a bottom piece that would be hinged together and a top piece hinged together with a grill piece. And this would be a very, very simple design. It would have to be operated by charcoal. One of my design goals was to get a propane operated grill. The third design, similar to the first, except the side slide into the middle. And this would allow the handle to be on the middle. And it originally designed to have wind extra covers on the side for wind screens, but that got eliminated through the design process. Choice 3 was determined to be the best, but many of the components from one were incorporated into that because they were very similar designs. Many changes happened through the design process. The decision was based on the size, ease of transformation, estimated weight, cooking method, and style. 1 and 3 were propane operated, while design 2 was charcoal. This is the exploded view of my grill. You can't see a lot of screws. But the concept is that the sides slide into the middle pieces, and then they're held in place by 3 thumb screws for each piece. And then the sides are also, they extend out beyond the middle piece a little bit, so they have a separate hinge piece too for an extra bit of sturdiness. The grill has 2 hinges, and that folds out, become full length, and the burner was really tricky. I was trying to come up with a design, and what actually has to happen is the consumer has to, is a couple extra thumb screws to hold the burner in place on the left side, which is where the propane attachment would be. They actually have to take it out and then swivel the middle section out and swivel the right section out and put it back in and screw it back in, and then do the reverse after it cools down after use. So my animations. Switch to USB. Opens and closes. that doesn't show closing. The grill is it sliding out and then it would open out. Just the thumb screws come out, the grill will come out and then open like in the other animation. The burner comes out, and I have an animation show how the burner circles out. pulls out, like, tools out like that to become full length. This was a rendered view of the, and in this view the grill is fully extended, the boner is fully extended, so you can see what it looks like in operating mode. Difficulties, I had difficulties with the animations. The rotating parts, I had to take a lot of snapshots because if I tried to just rotate with a couple, it would do like with someone's wheel did, it would come way off the part. And even with the animations I have, it kind of moves from the axis as it goes around. And getting things to align properly was difficult. Another thing was the actual design, figuring how the pieces would slide together, and especially the burner, how that would be able to go from a compact size to a full size was difficult. Modeling the sides, I had to use the blend feature, and getting the sizes right was a bit tricky, and the burner was just a little bit difficult. In conclusion, I think my project was successful. I learned a lot more about the animation process doing this, and I would definitely like to continue to improve the product with more time, and I'd add other features. An electric starter would be top of that list. Right now, you'd have to use grill matches to actually light the grill. Any questions?
How big did you want the grill to be? Like, how big was it?
I mean, it's about 2 feet this way, lengthwise, and about 9 inches deep in operating mode. Wanted to get that. It was about the size of a normal grill. It collapses down to about 11 by 9, so, and it's about 6 inches tall. Oh, one other thing, the cost, the average cost was about $100. It was one at up to $160 for a grill, and the estimated cost for my grill was about $165.
Yeah, for the burner, the animation you said, it basically, like holds back into place.
Mm-hmm.
Like how are they connected to each other? Like, is there a hinge?
It's a small like tube swivel thing. Okay. So the gas would just actually go through that into the next.
Do you need like a similar diameter tube inside the grill too? Because there would be uneven spacing of gas. But the last burner would.
In the user manual. The primary cooking side would be the left side, and then like the right side would be more for warming. You can roll that way as you cook the food. Anything else? All right.